Hey guys, welcome to another video. My name is Tejas and I have started this channel for all the master's applicants to make the application process easier. So anyways, this video is about statement of purpose, which is a very, very important document for your process. So let's not waste much time and get started. So what is an SOP? So SOP is an essay or a document that tells the university about you or lets the university get to know you. So as I've pointed out in my previous profile building video, which I'll link here, it is a very, very unique document. The reason why is that it sets your profile apart, because everyone has GPA, everyone has research experience, everyone has work experience, etc. But SOP tells the university like how you got there, how you overcame your challenges, like what challenges you faced, etc. So it is a pretty important document and you do not want to mess it up. So now let's get started with drafting your SOP. So gather everything you did in the last 2-3 years, which is your hackathons, some courses you did online or undergrad courses, which you can mention it in your SOP. Then research experience, work experience, research papers, anything. So just jot down everything, because it is not expected that you will remember everything you did in the last 2-3 years. So take your time and gather everything out. So next is thinking about the structure of your SOP. So it is a vital step, because you don't just want to randomly fit stuff like taking internship and taking course and just fitting there one after other. So that's why just think about a flow. So for example, the first line you're writing about your internship, and the next line you're writing about some courses you've done which are not related to each other. So that's gonna make the reader disinterested, and hence there you go, you lost an admit. So that's why you don't want to do it. So follow a structure. So here's an example of a structure. So first, of course, the introduction. This is a most important aspect of your SOP, because when the reader is reading your SOP, he or she will always go for the introduction, and it is the first impression of your SOP. So talk about your course, state exactly what is your course name. So for example, my course name was Master of Computer Science in Applied Artificial Intelligence. So I wrote the entire thing. That's why I state the entire course. So next is body. In this, talk about your journey in the last 2-3 years in technical terms. So what I mean is, don't put random stuff like I went hiking and I was thinking something about let's say AI and while sitting on a stone. Please don't do that. You're writing a SOP for masters, not about undergrad. So hence, write everything in technical terms, like how you decided to pursue for masters, why you decided to pursue masters, what challenges you faced in the past 2-3 years while let's say interning in a company, or you were doing a project and you faced some problems. So how you overcame the problems and what you learned, and all of these should be justified by the course you're applying for. Also, it helps to put some catchy words, and by catchy words, I don't mean like fancy words which are like used in GRE, verbal and all. So for example, I had worked on COVID-19 projects while I was interning, and they were in the field of AI and machine learning. So I had put these words, COVID-19, ML, AI, in my SOP, and also most importantly, these words and these sentences were justifying what I had written previously in my previous paragraph or previous statement. So hence, don't just put randomly the catchy words. Put all the justified statements, put all the justified words, and see that there's a flow, there's a proper flow in your SOP. So next tip would be emphasizing on your research experience or research work, because research is something that can set your profile apart. So hence, the more you can write in detail about your research work, it would be great. Don't just write like the entire thing what you did. Just mention what you are doing, what you did, how is it important, what challenges you faced, what you learned, and why is it important for your course or for you. So if you have written some research papers, you can cite them, like you can just put the name of your research paper and then cite them in the footer. In the citation, you can mention the conference name, journal name. This basically shows that you are a research-oriented person, and it is not a harm to cite your paper. That's completely fine. Now, next is divide your SOP in multiple paragraphs, like one paragraph for internship, one for paragraph for your research experience or papers, one paragraph for courses, one paragraph for hackathons, etc. Just make sure your paragraph is not big enough, because the reader might wander off because of the entirely huge paragraph. That's why I keep your paragraph short. So finally, coming to the conclusion, don't write conclusion, but that's a paragraph. In that, you can write about why you have chosen this particular university, why is it unique to you, why not go for other universities. Some, let's say you can write about some labs and all which are in, you have been looking for, and you are interested in working in the labs, etc. Also, what are your plans after graduation? You don't have to write specifics. You can just mention about you want to develop something and want to help in something, etc. And finally, end the SOP by thanking them. Like I had written, thank you for considering my application. Thank you for time and considering my application, something like that. So it just shows decency. Now, some more points on the SOP. Don't copy your SOP from your resume. Please don't do that. For example, the admission committee, just read your resume. Like, yeah, you have graduated this year, you have this CGPA, you have interned here, etc., etc. And then they are reading your SOP and they just find that you have written the entire same thing. That's why they'll just throw the SOP and you lost the admit. So don't copy your resume. Instead, you can write about the internship like this. For example, in the month of something, I got this amazing opportunity to work at this company, where I was chosen, or I was selected among all the interns, all the employees, to be a part of some research work, and which was then published in this. We had some challenges faced in between and blah 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 blah. So you got the point. Don't just copy your resume in that. It doesn't make sense. So next point is reviewing the draft. I don't remember which point is that, but so here's the thing. SOP, writing an SOP takes a huge amount of time. It is a long process. I personally took 3 months for drafting my final SOP. I was enhancing it, I was reviewing it, I was rewriting it, I was updating it till I was satisfied, yes, this is the SOP I want, this is the SOP I want to send. So once you write your first draft, you can give your SOP for review. You can contact your seniors, ask them politely if you can just review my SOP. So the reason why I'm asking you to give your SOP to others is because after reading it multiple times, you might overlook some words, some sentences that might be critical, that might be vital. So hence, a fresh reader might point it out and you might get a good SOP. So hence, contact your seniors. Not even seniors, you can contact your friends, relatives, family, etc. Just there's no harm if they can read it. So also, the final point is take the suggestion, not the advice. The final SOP should be yours, and you should have written it. So that's why that is important, because it will maintain the novelty. It will maintain the uniqueness that you have written in the SOP, and it is about you. It is the thought process is about you. So So the next point is, do not copy your SOP from the seniors. Please don't do this, because once you copy your SOP and send it to the university sets a plagiarism check, and if your SOP even matches with the other SOP like around 30-40%, you might get blacklisted and you might not be able to apply again. So hence, please don't do that. SOP is about you and you should write your SOP. Don't copy your SOP from anyone. So the final point is checking your grammar. So please check the grammar of your SOP. One common mistake everyone does is not putting a space after comma. This is a very common mistake. Please make sure you have checked the grammar. You can check your grammar by using Grammarly. I had personally used it. You can use the free version. It checks all the grammar and all. Also, you can buy its premium version, or you can share your account with your friend or colleague, etc. It will just divide the price. So hence, make sure you check the grammar and these mistakes are avoided, because the reader wants to at least read the SOP with proper grammar. Imagine reading 1000 SOPs and some random grammar is used, so it will just frustrate him or her, and again your SOP will be thrown out and you will just lose that. So there it is. I hope this video was helpful in any way, and I hope you draft your SOP sooner. So stay tuned, subscribe to the channel. I'm making some more videos about it. So bye for now. Thank you.